Freedom Caucus is turning on Marjorie Taylor Greene, and they want to boot the MAGA babe and her dirty ass feet to the curb, according to a Politico report. So let's get into what that article had to say. At least two hardliners have discussed and proposed to Freedom Caucus Chair Scott Perry, trying to boot members who are no longer meet the group's standards, according to three Republicans with knowledge of the talks who spoke on condition of anonymity. While the lawmakers did not disclose who they want to oust, there were strong signals that it was none other than the Marge. And if you can believe it, they don't want to oust her for being too right wing. They want to oust her because they think she's not right wing enough. Jewish Space Lasers Lady isn't right wing enough for the Freedom Caucus. So Politico reported that some in the Freedom Caucus have focused on Greene, who's become a close ally of Speaker Kevin McCarthy, to illustrate their fears that certain group members are too aligned with GOP leaders and too outwardly critical of the group when it splits on certain issues. Representative Byron Donalds was quoted saying, "There are frustrations." Now, here is how caucus leader Scott Perry reacted. Perry told Politico that he denied the removal requests, yet the fact that he had to illustrates how the group continues to struggle with its identity since former President Donald Trump left office, not to mention the acrimony caused in the lead up to the handshake deals McCarthy made to win conservative votes during January's grueling speakership battle. Now, caucus member Representative Ralph Norman elaborated on Perry's stance. He said, "The speaker's race, there was some difference in opinion. The debt ceiling, there were differences of opinion, and we had to get 80% on any major issue that we take positions on. On some big issues, we have not been able to get there. We're at a critical point right now. As for internal concerns about Greene, Norman said he wasn't suggesting pushing her out, but replied, she's been critical of us for a long time." Now, adding to this drama is the little cat fight that Marge and Bobo had on the House floor this week. Of course, Hale gossip tabloid Politico had to get on Bobo's comments, and here is what she said. Bobo demurred when asked where she stands on the Freedom Caucus's purge pitch. "If something comes up," she said, "then we'll address it." Of course, if you don't remember, Marjorie Taylor Greene referred to Lauren Boebert as a little bitch earlier this week. Cenk, I'm really reveling in this infighting within the Republican Party. So often all the news about infighting we see coming from the Democratic side, and the Republican Party has really had all of their ducks in a row. It seems like Kevin McCarthy isn't really able to command with having the speakership. He's not able to command his party in the same way that they have been organized in the past.
Okay, then part of my opinion might surprise you. So I think there's one thing that the Freedom Caucus is totally right about. So I'll get to that in a second. So first, perfect sign of the times. Marjorie Taylor Greene, not radical enough for some Republicans. I mean, that's it. I rest my case on the Republican Party. Like, if this party thinks she's not crazy enough, there's something deeply, deeply wrong with the party. Okay. Now, Freedom Caucus and I'll say just Democrats, because the Progressive Caucus is gigantic and they're not, two-thirds of them are not progressive. So I take that as the two theoretical extremes, right? Freedom Caucus is extreme right, and just Democrats are not extreme in their opinions on economic issues at all. They're in the center of the country, which I'll get back to in a second, but in Washington are considered the left end of the spectrum. So, well, I say it's they're one and one, okay? Just Democrats are very much right about the policy. Freedom Caucus is very wrong. But on the politics, the Freedom Caucus is correct and Just Democrats are wrong. So here's what I mean. Freedom Caucus pushes their own party very significantly. They fight and fight and fight, and they won't give in until they got a ton of concessions. So they keep getting concession after concession after concession, right? The Just Democrats, who I helped to form, and I really, 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 you can call them the squad, you can call them anything you like, okay? I really wanted them to fight the establishment. In fact, a lot of you guys, you voted for them, you donated to them, you volunteered for them, because you wanted them to fight the establishment. And so far, they have chosen not to. They've shown a tiny, tiny, tiny pushback on a couple of things, but overall, they're like, oh, Biden said it, so I guess it must be true. And they literally, the Progressive Caucus at one point went with a strategy called trust Biden. That's the world's worst political strategy. That means you won't push back and you won't get any concessions. You're choosing not to use your power because it makes you uncomfortable and giving away all of your leverage. So on the politics, sorry, but the Freedom Caucus is totally right. And our side is totally wrong. But the problem is, when you get to the policy, what is Freedom Caucus trying to push for? They're like, Marjorie Taylor Greene is not radical enough. We really wanted to make sure that we did not lift the debt ceiling. But every economist in the world agrees that the world economy would collapse if you didn't lift the debt ceiling. They're like, yeah, so what? Yeah, that's awesome, man. Let's destroy the world. Well, Marjorie's gonna take too long with the Jewish space lasers. Let's just do it. Let's kill them. Let's do it now. Destroy the economy. Right? And then meanwhile, the Just Democrats are for like paid family leave that 84% of the country wants. And they're like, well, we probably shouldn't assist. So that's your whole spectrum.
Cenk, I totally agree with you, and I'm so glad that you said that, because it's one of the most frustrating things as a Democrat to watch happen when, you know, there's these policies that are universally popular that all they have to do is run on them. And instead they go, let's kind of stick towards the center. We want to grab some more of these moderates who are really, like, I would say far center right. You know, it's a nonsense plan that doesn't work. And then I fully agree that when you look at what Republicans are doing, especially far right Republicans, their ideas are insane, but the way that they play politically is the way to win politically. And that's why they are in a lot of these places winning to our detriment. At the same time, there is an interesting thing happening that, you know, as dangerous as it is, it's kind of curious to see where it goes, where Republicans have essentially, you know, it's the dog that caught its own tail. And as a result, like they are losing support. It's, you know, we saw it immediately after the repeal of Roe v. Wade, where, okay, well, they got this wild far right idea that they wanted. They totally succeeded. Congratulations. Where did everybody go? And watching this kind of thing, watching a lot of the infighting, it feels like it reflects seeing Trump as not nearly as powerful as he was at the height of his presidency, or going into 2020. And so they're almost like trying to decide, like, are we a chicken without a head, or do we have a chance of pulling it out? And they feel like the only way forward is to just go more and more extreme and farther right, and even attacking some of their farthest right, champions like Marjorie Taylor Greene. And so it's an incredibly weird thing to watch. And so, yeah, on the one hand, I agree that some of the stuff they're doing is very effective, which is terrible. But on the other hand, it's like watching something slowly collapsing in on itself and people pushing against the walls. And I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know if they're really gonna make it or not. And, you know, obviously I hope not.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.